This is a hemlock tree, a very common tree in the Appalachian Mountains, but unfortunately it is under attack by a non-native insect, the hemlock woolly adelgid.
If you do nothing, you're going to lose the keystone species, eastern hemlock, Carolina hemlock.
If we lose these hemlocks along our creeks, it will definitely impact the value of our creeks, the water quality, and what species are living there.
Fortunately, there are some things being done about it, and there are some things that you can do as well. So stick with me and you'll learn all about the adelgid and everything that you can do. Hi, I'm Kelly Oten. I'm a forest entomologist and extension specialist at NC State University. I've been studying the hemlock woolly adelgid since 2008, and the reason for that is because I love hemlock trees. They are large, beautiful trees that define the gorgeous mountain landscapes in the southern Appalachians, and really the reason I fell in love with this area and decided to live here. This is a beautiful hemlock tree, a large, long-lived tree. They can live for up to 800 years in our forest ecosystems. Let's look how to identify it. I want to show you some key characteristics to look for. It is an evergreen tree, meaning it keeps its needles year-round. But to tell it from other evergreens, you'll look up close at the needles, and underneath, you'll see two pale bands, and the needle itself is attached to the stems with its own stem. Now, how to tell if it's infested with adelgids? Look at that same underside, and at the base of those needles, you'll see this white, woolly, cottony-like substance. Underneath that cottony substance is the adelgid, a small insect about the size of a period on a piece of paper. The hemlock woolly adelgid is native to Asia and the Pacific Northwest. However, we know the population that we have here in the eastern United States that's invasive is from southern Japan when someone accidentally transported an infested southern Japanese hemlock into Virginia. Now, the adelgid got out, it started spreading to all of our native hemlocks and started killing them. And that's because our trees here don't have those adaptations to defend itself against this insect. That, and we don't have predators in place to help keep the populations of the adelgid low. Now, the way they kill the tree, they have very long straw-like mouthparts that goes into the tree and retrieves the nutrients of the tree, slowly weakening it, making its canopy go sparse and eventually die. Fortunately, this is not the end of the hemlocks. There's a lot of amazing people doing research to try to save these trees, including Lauren Gonzalez at NC State University.
I've been studying hemlock woolly adelgid for 5 years now, but I'm not alone in this. We have researchers at the local, state, and federal level working together in three main research areas. The first area is biological control. So this is, there's a stick, we call this beet sheeting because we are beating the tree. All right, so here we have a laricovious beetle. These are predators of hemlock woolly adelgid. So researchers in Tennessee actually traveled to Japan and found a laricovious beetle that is from the same area where HWA that was introduced here was found. So they brought it back to their lab and reared it for release in hopes of managing the adelgid populations here on the East Coast. The next area we really focus on is gene conservation and breeding for host resistance. We are currently collecting cones from across the hemlock range to maintain the genetic diversity of our eastern hemlock populations. Not only are we making sure that we maintain those, we're also looking for natural resistance that might occur in individuals where we have infestations, but these trees otherwise look completely healthy. This might be beneficial in breeding programs, for instance, where we can help identify and use those traits in future plantings of hemlock seedlings. The next is silviculture. We're actually standing right now in an experimental plot where we're looking at the effects of increased sunlight on our hemlock trees. So silviculture is just a fancy term for manipulating the forest stand to your particular outcome. In this case, we're actually trying to increase the amount of light and resources that these trees receive so they can better tolerate the infestation from the hemlock woolly adelgid.
Even though there's a lot of work being done around the state of North Carolina to help and save our hemlocks, as a landowner, there is something that you can do as well. I'm Brian Heath, I'm with the North Carolina Forest Service. I've been treating hemlocks for several years. The state of North Carolina has treated over 70,000 hemlocks, and I want to show you how you can do that using a chemical option to keep your hemlocks alive and healthy. First thing you need to do is make sure you have the proper protective equipment. You want to have your gloves on, chemical resistant gloves, a long sleeve shirt, long pants, and closed-in shoes. Imidacloprid is the active ingredient. You want to order or purchase Imidacloprid 2F. Usually comes in a gallon jug. This tree is 10 inches in diameter. Based on the chemical rate that we have mixed up, we've got 10 ounces of a chemical mixture mixed with water. We will first rake away the leaves and litter away from around the tree. Once that is cleared out, all you have to do is pour the chemical all the way around the tree. You want to make sure that you distribute it evenly around the tree, so that way it takes it up to the entire tree. If you leave one side out, that side of the tree is not going to be as protected and you may have problems. Once the mixture is completely around the tree, you can just cover up your mulch and then you're done. That's all it takes.
Now you know all about the hemlock woolly adelgid and the many ways we combat this invasive pest. And you also have a lot of reasons to hope about the future of this beautiful tree.